Greetings of the day. I am recording these slides for an assignment which has been given us for the faculty development program being organized by KTHM College along with Human Resource Development Center and SPP University Pune. The topic of my presentation is Sign Language Recognition in Complex Background. I am Garima Joshi, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, UIT, Punjab University, Chandigarh. So the basic motivation behind this topic is that Indian Sign Language is being used by the hearing impaired people in India to communicate among themselves and with others. But the problem is that the people who don't know Indian Sign Language, because it is not very popular and no formal training is given rigorously for understanding Indian Sign Language by majority, therefore people don't understand it, and there lies a communication gap between a person who is using a sign language and a person who doesn't know sign language. So, as an engineer, we can think of a system which can automatically convert the signs into a text or a speech. So, such a system would be called as sign language recognition system. And we need to have a sign language as an integral part of our education system. And to assist sign language teaching and learning process, interactive tools would be required. And such a sign language recognition system can prove useful in such cases also. As we have seen that sign language, for example, the alphabets in sign language are signed in certain hand gestures as shown here. So, A, B, C, D has certain hand gestures, and you can see that these gestures are not simple gestures. They are made with double hands and few of them are single hand also. And if a background is uniform, it is easier to recognize these gestures. But since we wear different clothes as a human being, so these interpreting these gestures under different background condition, also when illumination is varying, becomes very difficult. So what we have done is we have acquired a data set of around 100 images per alphabet, and then we have synthesized into a complex background data set by adding complex background into it. And the total number of images in the data set is now 2600. For a complex background data set, this work has been done in year 2017. And during that time, I was doing my PhD work. It was found that histogram of oriented gradients, they proved very useful in recognition of pedestrian detection in complex background. But in that case, the classification was single class classification. That means in any complex situation, we could detect a human being. Either he is walking, the person is walking or standing or sitting. But the feature set worked very good in complex background condition. Now, when we thought of applying this process in a sign language recognition domain, the challenge was that it is not a single class classification problem. It is a multi-class classification problem. Most of the gestures are quite complex. Then complexity further increases if we introduce a complex background into it. So, to implement this into a sign language recognition domain required another set of experimentation and to find out what could be done to improve the accuracy of the system using hog parameters. So for this, we need to understand what is histogram of oriented gradient technique and how it is calculated. So it became an objective of our research paper that we need to identify what set of hog parameters would give us the best and the optimal results. And then we demonstrated certain design of experimentation technique into it. And then we introduced a new technique which is being used by researchers in various fields, mostly in case of mechanical engineering, which is known as the Gucci and Topsis technique, a combination of this. Some people have also applied it in a simulation domain such as machine learning. And now we put an effort to use this technique to determine the hog parameters, a perfect set of hog parameters that would give us the higher accuracy in terms of recognition of sign language alphabets. So the proposed methodology has 5 steps. So first we will see how hog can be used for sign language recognition. And in this process, we need to identify what are the hog parameters which we can vary. What are the sign language recognition system parameters which we are looking for? I mean, accuracy is one, computational time is another, feature set size is another parameter. How can we introduce a preference order in these performance metrics? Then, when you have so much to do, you cannot just apply trial and error method. So we applied a design of experiments where we use this technique to determine what would be the best combination of parameters. So following this, a Taguchi Topsis analysis is applied, and then when we get this best combination of hog parameters, we apply these to calculate multiple levels of hog features from a same image, and then a features vector is determined, which is given to a classifier, and there is a result and discussion section at the end. If we see into a hog feature calculation extraction technique, you can see the image is first divided into various cells, a small cells of different sizes, and for each cell, the histogram of gradient is calculated. So basically, gradient is actually the edges in the image, and we try to find out what are the various edges in the image, and then we pool them and find a histogram for those edges. For example, if there are the lines of 0 to 10 degree in inclination, they are put into one domain. Then 11 to 20 degree inclination are put into another bin, and so on. For example, here one parameter known as bin size is given. That means bin size is basically we divide these inclination or gradients from, say, if we are taking 0 to 180 degree into, if we divide it into 6 bins, it will be each bin of 30 degree. So all the gradients which fall between 0 to 30 will be put into this bin. So on y-axis, we have how many number of gradients we have found in between 0 to 30 degree, then 30 to 60 and so on. And then we normalize this y-axis, so we get the value between 0 to 1. So this image is, you can see, is converted into bins of, into the histograms of gradients. And then for each block, a combination of certain set of block can be taken as set of cells is taken as, which is known as blocks, and for which we normalize these histograms. And ultimately, we get a feature sector of normalized histogram of gradients. So we find that here there are several parameters which we can vary. For example, image size is one parameter, gamma variation is another, cell size is another. There is a technique where we can calculate the blocks by overlapping the cells or non-overlapping cells. And then what is the final normalization technique which we are applying. Therefore, if we say what is a Hogg-based sign language recognition system, it is basically a system where first we do pre-processing, and in pre-processing, because our data set is a grayscale image data set, we are only resizing the images and varying its contrast by gamma variation. Then for the Hogg parameters, we find out multiple level of Hogg parameters where we can vary the cell size, the bin size, the normalization technique, and after extracting the feature set, we are giving it into a classifier. Here we are using a support vector machine as a classifier because it gave us best result in all the earlier experimentation which we have done. I would also like to specify that these set or combination or parameters which we have taken included various preliminary experiments which we had performed and we have published. So design of experimentation technique always requires some experience of the experimenter. You can just not jump into an experiment without any preliminary experience. So whenever you plan to apply this technique, the warning is that you must first see the behavior of the system in detail, and then you pull in these parameters. What should be the image size variation? What is the minimum size and the maximum size? How gamma can be varied? What can be the cell size variation? Does it depend on image size? What is the block size variation? What is the bin size variation? What various normalization techniques can be taken? These all require some preliminary experimentation which should be performed very carefully. So I'm stopping here, and the details of the system, how the experiments are performed, and results will be discussed in next video. Thank you so much.